Valvular disease. We'll simply talk about valvular disease. Tricuspid atresia with VSCD, absent connection between right atrium, right ventricle, hypoblastic right ventricle, VSCD present. The schedules about valvular disease, congenital fatal heart, and appearance in various chamber view. And for chamber view, absent flow from right atrium to right ventricle, blood from right atrium flow across foraminal van to left atrium, and then in the diastole to left ventricle. Unilateral perfusion across left ventricle inflow tract, left to right shunt, across the VSD into small right ventricle. So blood coming to right ventricle come from left ventricle through VSD in tricuspid atresia with VSD. And five chamber view non-contributory or depending on the ventriculo-arterial connection. Three vessel view pulmonary stenosis often evident with anti-grade flow. Tricuspid dysplasia is Bechstein's anomaly. Tricuspid valve dysplasia, second valve leaflets, Bechstein anomaly, apical displacement of tricuspid valve leaflets within the right ventricle. In full chamber view, we see severe tricuspid regurgitation, as we see later. Spectral dobral can be used to measure pressure gradient and duration of regurgitation. Five chamber view, non-contributory in this condition. Three vessel view showing tiny pulmonary artery when associated with obstruction of right ventricle outflow tract, anti-grade flow in pulmonary stenosis, retrograde flow in severe forms. Right atrial dilatation, gross cardiomegaly in severe cases. Pulmonary atresia with intact ventricular septum, as we talk. Right ventricular hypoblastic, normal sized or rarely dilated, poor contractility of right ventricle, reduced right tricuspid valve movement, our atletic pulmonary valve. Four chamber view, we see reduced or absent tricuspid flow, tricuspid regurgitation may be evident during systole, rule out ventricular coronary fistula. Five chamber view, non-contributory. Three vessel view, lack of anti-grade flow across the pulmonary valve, retrograde flow through DA, pulmonary trunk, smaller caliber than the ascending aorta as we see before. Pulmonary stenosis, we talk about him before. First, to talk about valvular lesion, aortic stenosis. Aortic stenosis, narrowing of semilunar valves, post-stenotic dilatation of the ascending aorta. In four chamber view, non-contributory. In five chamber view, anti-grade turbulent flow with liaising in this characteristic pulse Doppler show high velocities, more than 2 meters per second. Three vessel view show turbulent flow in dilated proximal aortic arch. Coarctation of aorta. Narrowing of distal aortic arch or of the whole arch is in tabular hypoplasia. Left ventricle may be smaller than right ventricle. VSD may be present in some cases with tabular hypoplasia. For a chamber view, left ventricle may be smaller than right ventricle. Five chamber view, anti-grade flow across the aortic valve. Aorta may be of small caliber. Aortic arch is smaller than ductal arch. Aortic arch flow usually anti-grade unless severe. Tetralogy of Phelps. VSCD overriding aorta, infundibular pulmonary stenosis, right ventricular hypertrophy not evident prenatally. Non-contributory in most cases. Y-shaped systolic flow from both ventricle into overriding aorta, five chamber view. Anti-grade turbulent flow in three vessel view in tiny pulmonary trunk in severe cases, retrograde flow across our through ductus arteriosus. Aortic stenosis. We talk about aortic valve disease, congenital fatal heart aortic valve disease. Aortic stenosis, valvular stenosis 2/3, subvalvular stenosis 1/3, supravalvular stenosis is this type of aortic stenosis. We see in this case, in fatal heart ultrasound, in case aortic stenosis, hypertrophic left ventricle, we see second wall. Hypertrophy in left ventricle, encroached in the lumen, decreased lumen. Dilated left ventricle, poor contractility. This condition not hypertrophic, it's dilated, increased lumen, increased measurement chambers of the left ventricles. As we see in P mode, increased distance measurement of the left ventricle measurement. We see either hypertrophic, dilated left ventricle. In aortic stenosis, hypertrophic left ventricle, second aortic valve. This is left ventricles, hypertrophied and second aortic valve. Slightly enlarged aortic root with high velocity, turbulent flow and the mitral regear. This is ventricle, this outlet aorta, slightly enlarged aortic root with high velocity, turbulent flow, and we see it using bicolor Doppler and mitral regear, left ventricles, and this is mitral regear, this is left atrium, as we see regear of the mitral valve. It is allowed direction of flow from left atrium to left ventricles during the stool, this thing during the stool closed. We see regear of flow. Heart anomaly is detectable in the five chamber view during systole. Turbulent flow across the stenotic aortic valve, left ventricle. Turbulent flow through stenotic aortic, this is very important. Aortic stenosis, Doppler through aortic valve refills, increased systolic velocity. Increased systolic velocity with maximal velocity of 218 centimeters per second. Indicative of severe aortic stenosis, this is very important. We see increased velocity through aortic valve. This is indicative of aortic stenosis, as we see aortic area. It's a Doppler study. Aortic stenosis, turbulent flow. Turbulent flow. We see green pixels as seen in five chamber view. Continuous wave Doppler allows quantification of stenosis. This continuous wave Doppler, and we see aortic flow and the peak maximal velocity, and we see aortic flow profile, okay, to be pressure gradient across our continuous wave. Second aortic valve, and you see this left ventricle is aorta, second aortic valve, this eliasing turbulent flow, but the Doppler show high systolic velocity, 2 cm/s. Aortic valve, interrupted aortic arch. This is left ventricle, as you see small, this right ventricle. This is ductal arch, ductal arch, ascending aorta, descending aorta. Interrupted aortic arch, hypoplastic, interrupted. Aortic valve stenosis, so bilateral superior vena cava. Three facet view on sonography shows that the ascending aorta enlarged. We see him because both stenotic dilatation. This is V2 vena cava. Dilated ascending aorta, post stenotic dilatation. This is a result of aortic stenosis. Aortic atresia and the mitral valve hypoplasia. Aortic atresia, hypoplastic left heart. Hypoplastic left heart syndrome. And this is aortic atresia. As you see this aorta, this arch. Decrease the caliber as we see atretic aorta. Aortic atresia, and mitral valve hypoplasia, hypoplastic mitral valve syndrome. Coarctation of the aorta, less than 1% of congenital heart disease. Congenital stenosis, just distal to left subclavian artery. Congenital stenosis in descending aorta, just leaving left subclavian artery branch, last branch. Recurrence risk equal 2% first sieve, 6% two sieves. When ductus closes tissue at insertion on proximal ascending aorta constricts post ductal coarctations. Six arch forms ductus arteriosus, fourth arch for aorta. Coarctation of the aorta, narrowing just distal to take off left subclavian artery. Hypoplasia of the fourth arch, visualization of arch insensitive, large right ventricle and the pulmonary artery relative to and aorta. Coarctation of the aorta flow across tricuspid valve over mitral valve more than 2:1. Normally less than 1.8:1. Associated with other cardiac defects, bicuspid aortic valve, VECD, ESCD, 10% association with chromosomal anomalies, Spitz syndrome. Coarctation of the aorta, hypoplasia of the aorta, this right ventricle, this is left ventricle, hypoplastic. We see here the origin leafing of left subclavian, and we see coarctation of the aorta narrowing of this area with hypoplasia of the aorta, hypoplasia ventricle. Coarctation tabular hypoplasia of the aortic arch. Coarctation and tabular hypoplasia of the aortic arch, ventricular disproportion with dominance of right ventricle, as we see because small left ventricles, small aortic and compared to the dural ductal arch in transverse view, this is aortic arch, this is pulmonary artery. This is, as we see, aortic arch small, aortic arch small and narrowing. and small and tortuous aortic with impression of a sheath in the longitudinal view, impression of the sheath in the longitudinal view. Coarctation hypoplasia of the aortic arch. Coarctation of the aortic arch is very evident. Aorta, aorta, arch, arch, and the origin of subclavian aftering. Decreased narrowing of the aorta, but start of descending aorta, coarctation of the aortic arch. Tricuspid valve. We talk about tricuspid valve, next valve in our. Tricuspid valve left axis deviation. Why? An SCD is vital right to left shunt, leading to central sinuses. Right to left shunt. Three variations are known. Why ESCD vital? Because flow from ESCD to right ventricle is impedance for tricuspid atresia. So blood in the left, blood in the right atrium, flow from right atrium to right ventricle, impedant by tricuspid atresia obstacles. So blood in the right atrium, where he go? He must go to systemic circulation. Goes through ESCD to left atrium and some to the left ventricle. Three variations are known. Case classification. Tricuspid atresia with intact ventricular septum. Tricuspid atresia with large VSCD or pulmonary atresia. Atresia with a large VSCD and transposition cells. Tricuspid dysplasia with extreme cardiomegaly. This is tricuspid dysplasia with extreme cardiomegaly. This mitral valve. This is left ventricle, right ventricle. This is what this is right atrium enlarged because of obstruction here in tricuspid valve. So we must have ESCD to blood to go from right atrium, so left atrium, so to the left ventricle through mitral valve. And we see by Barcel Doppler study high velocity across this area. Epstein malformation of the tricuspid valve, as we see right atrium. And the CEV junction, atrophic junction, tricuspid valve insertions, large right atrium, as the obstruction at the level of the tricuspid valve. Epstein malformation of tricuspid valve, leaflets of tricuspid valve are displaced apically compared to the EV junction, and there is a massive tricuspid regurgitation. The massive tricuspid regurg, apical displacement of the tricuspid regurg, massive. Tricuspid dysplasia, large right atrium, and right ventricle. Cardiomegaly, enlargement to the right side of the heart and the right atrium in particular, massive regurgitation across a normally inserted tricuspid valve. The massive regurgitation of flow we see in elysian color, reversed colors, valve. As we see severe valvular insufficiency with retrograde flow, give mosaic appearance, we said this before, and see one image like this before, we repeat and repeat this. Same fetus with Doppler M mode. Show diastolic and systolic perfusion of the valve, indicating holosystolic tricuspid insufficiency. This is invaders with Doppler M mode. We see diastolic and systolic perfusion of the valve, indicating holosystolic tricuspid insufficiency. Differential diagnosis of tricuspid insufficiency. Slight tricuspid valve regurgitation. One. Second, heart defect with primary dysplasia of tricuspid valve, heart defect with optional tricuspid insufficiency, like Epstein anomaly, tricuspid valve dysplasia, EV canal, hypoplastic left heart, mitral atresia with DORF, coarctation of the aorta. Heart defect is disease and disease with right ventricular obstruction, pulmonary atresia, pulmonary stenosis, constriction of ductus arteriosus, volume overload, frequent tricuspid insufficiency with mitral insufficiency, like fetal anemia, peripheral EV fistula, sick acceptor in 20 transfusion, cardiac reticular circulation, severe arrhythmia, tachycardia, bradycardia, myocardial dysfunction, frequent tricuspid insufficiency with mitral insufficiency, the myocardial infection, cardiomyopathy, myocardial damage, and so on. This is differential tricuspid insufficiency. Diagram of tricuspid atresia with VSCD. As we see, this is right ventricles, this is left ventricles. And we see, this is left ventricle and the left atrium. This right ventricle and right atrium, as we see, enlarged. Right atrium, tricuspid atresia. So blood goes through left ventricles to the right ventricles. And we see this is pulmonary artery, tricuspid atresia, enlargement of the right atrium and the VSCD. Small right ventricle, hypoplasia of the tricuspid valve and starting to the pulmonary trunk, small size. Tricuspid valve dysplasia. Tricuspid valve dysplasia with severe tricuspid insufficiency, as we see. And the cardiomegaly, retrograde flow from right ventricle to right atrium is seen blue turbulent flow coded by green pixel, like this is blue and turbulent green pixels retrograde flow. As we see, pulmonary atritic valve with tricuspid insufficiency. This is right ventricle, right atrium. Right atrium enlarged, this right ventricle. As we see, this is also, as we see in these images, as we see pulmonary trunk, this is right ventricle, right atrium, as we see enlarged with valve dysplasia. Tricuspid atresia and VSCD, as we see this VSCD, and this is left atrium, left ventricle, right atrium, right ventricle, as we see dysplasia or atresia of tricuspid valve SCD. Tricuspid atresia and VSCD, color Doppler demonstrate flow from left atrium to left ventricle and VSCD to right ventricle. Flow from left atrium, right ventricle, and through VSCD to left atrium, left ventricle, and from left ventricle to right ventricle through D. Four dimensional flow demonstrate render the construction of tricuspid regurgitation get shown. This tricuspid regurgitation get reformations on four actions ultrasound. Tricuspid valve insertion lower in the right ventricle with tricuspid insufficiency. This tricuspid valve insertion low must be like here, like tricuspid, with regurgitations as with color tricuspid insufficiency. Tricuspid atresia with the VSCD, as we see, flow from right left atrium, right atrium through ESCD to left atrium, and left atrium to the left ventricle through VSCD to right ventricle. If a tricuspid atresia and VSCD are show the direction of flow due to atresia of the tricuspid valve by doublet study. Right atrium, left ventricle, right ventricle through ESCD, VSCD must be essentials for life. This is tricuspid atresia, right ventricle hypoplastic or absent? Hypoplastic right ventricle. Color doublet demonstrates the absence of minimal flow from right atrium to right ventricle. Pulmonary artery, as we see, aortic arch, pulmonary artery hypoplasia, pulmonary artery, pulmonary valve, with what pulse duplex study, high peak systolic image, tricuspid atresia, tricuspid dysplasia with Epstein anomaly, characteristic finding that of massively enlarged right atrium, massive enlarged right atrium, small right ventricle, and a small pulmonary artery, Doppler can be shown to state regurgitation with right atrium, this regurgitation with through right atrium, and duplex study, pulse wave show high duplex study, high peak systolic pulmonary valve. Severe tricuspid regurgitations. Pulsed wave Doppler is not useful due to the aliasing phenomenon and the maximal velocities that can be assessed are 180 centimeters per second. Continuous wave Doppler translucent allows assessment of very high velocities, in this case 420 centimeters. As we see, surface rendered view, three dimensional view, and we see this image also mitral valve, and this is tricuspid valve at 3, and you see regurgitation of tricuspid valve on the left right valve regurgitation of the and on the right valve regurgitation in vitals with EV septal defects. This tricuspid regurgitation, this tricuspid also regurgitation. This is small, this is large with Epstein anomaly associated with tricuspid insufficiency with tricuspid disease. Epstein anomaly, tricuspid insufficiency, pulmonary stenosis, ESCD, right axis deficient. Shift of the right EV septum. Atrializations of the right ventricle, part of the right atrium is formed by ventricular wall. Atrialization of the right ventricle. Tricuspid valve arising distal to the annulus, tricuspid insufficiency, will default the right outflow tract, only contracted part on the right side. Association ESCD, right to left shunt. Tricuspid insufficiency, pulmonary stenosis, ESCD, axis deficient. Epstein anomaly is the 1% current risk. Apical displacement tricuspid valve, small right ventricle, right atrium grossly dilated because valve incompetent. Epstein anomaly associated with the ESCD, VP, WPW syndrome, 30%, right ventricle outflow obstruction, pulmonary stenosis, congenital stress of heart failure in utero from tricuspid again. Surgery to replace tricuspid valve, arrhythmia is frequent, dilated left atrium. Epstein anomaly, dilated left atrium, tricuspid valve insufficiency, tricuspid atresia, left ventricle, as we see this view. This is left ventricle, left atrium, large left atrium, as we see. As we see ESCD, and we see tricuspid insufficiency. Epstein anomaly. Epstein anomaly, large right atrium is seen. large right atrium is seen. It's very important. And we see left atrium, this is left ventricle. Large right atrium, my intracuspid insufficiency, right ventricle. Epstein anomaly for a chamber view. Apical displacement to tricuspid valve from level of the annulus with severe dilatation of the right atrium, consistent with Epstein anomaly. Apical displacement of the tricuspid valve below level of the annulus with severe dilatations of the right atrium. And we see ASCD, indicated measurement. As we see, this is left ventricles. Epstein anomaly, very second and apical displaced tricuspid valve, severe cardiomegaly, severely dilated right atrium. Severely dilated right atrium. That's these images. Severely dilated. Epstein anomaly, severely dilated right atrium. Tricuspid insufficiency. And we see. Epstein anomaly, tricuspid valve, three vessel view sonography. That mean pulmonary artery smaller than the ascending aorta. Mean pulmonary artery smaller than the ascending aorta. And we see this is ascending aorta, and this is veins, and this is ascending aorta, ductus arteriosus, pulmonary trunk, smaller than aorta, ascending aorta, ductus arteriosus, ascending, valve, and so on. Why pulmonary artery small? عشان pulmonary stenosis. Double aortic arch infarctus, as we see, this is double aortic arch infarctus, double aortic arch spine, and this is right aortic arch, and this is trachea, and this is aorta, and this is superior vena cava, and this is left arch. Double aortic arch and this image in fetus. So this is what. Fetal right side aortic arch. We talk about another arch. Right aortic arch is superior vena cava. This is ductus part. Right side aortic arch is one of the commonest anomalies associated with fibrosis sometimes. Right sided aortic arch. As we see, this is right sided aortic arch and this is trachea. Aortic arch right to the. And you see this multiple reference. We thank you to this reference. Thank you to all us to give him as paper and to read it in the very